This RAM upgrade is going to piss you off. This should be a simple 2-minute upgrade. But ASUS had different plans, and you're about to see why this upgrade sucks. I'll show you how to do it anyway, without breaking anything expensive in the process. Start by flipping your laptop over and taking out every visible screw. But grab some tape first, and number each one as you pull it out. Mix up these screw lengths, and you'll damage your laptop during reassembly. Think you got them all? There's actually one more hiding under this innocent-looking cover. Easy to miss, but it'll stop you from opening the case if you forget it. Lift this tiny cover with tweezers or a small screwdriver, then pull out the screw hiding underneath. Now you can safely open the case. Open the laptop slightly like this, it gives you better access to work around the edges. The case is still held by internal clips, so you'll need a plastic spudger for this. I'll link the exact tools and RAM options below. Insert the spudger here and work your way around the edges. You'll hear a small click when each clip releases. That's exactly what you want. Go slowly near the USB ports because the plastic here breaks easily if you rush. Patience is key. Some resistance is normal, but never force it. Once all clips are released, you can lift the top section slightly. But stop. These ribbon cables are still attached and incredibly fragile. Pull too hard and you'll destroy the keyboard connections. Here's the safe way. Flip up this little clip, like opening a tiny door. Then the cable slides out with zero force. Use the same gentle motion for the touchpad cable, and now you can safely pull away the palm rest completely. There we go. If this is helping you so far, hit that like button. It helps others find this video too. Now here's where things get interesting. Most laptops would show you the RAM slots right here, but not this one. ASUS decided to put the RAM on the other side of the motherboard, so we're just getting started. Before touching anything else, unplug the battery first. With no power flowing, there's zero risk of frying components. Three screws hold the battery in place. Take them out and tilt it up to unplug the connector safely. Now we need to unplug the Wi-Fi antenna. These connectors are tiny and break easily if forced. Three screws hold your drive assembly in place. Take them out and the whole thing slides free. Next, we'll unplug this USB connector cable, flip the little latch, and slide the cable out gently. Now unplug the speaker and fan cables from the motherboard. Always pull on the connector itself, not the wires. Time to unplug the display cable from the motherboard. Be very cautious here. This cable is expensive to replace. Take out the remaining motherboard screws. Now you'd think you can lift the motherboard out, right? Here's where this upgrade gets really frustrating. The display hinges are positioned right above the motherboard. That means you can't pull out the motherboard until you remove the entire screen assembly first. This is exactly why this upgrade is frustrating. Back in 2010, this would have been a 2-minute job with a simple cover panel. Now we have to unscrew all the hinge screws to free up the display assembly. The right hinge screws came out easily, but the left side screws were so tight, I had to press down so hard, I actually moved the laptop out of the picture. Sorry about that. After taking out all hinge screws, you can finally lift off the entire display assembly. Pull out the last motherboard screw, and now, finally, you can lift out the motherboard. Flip it over and there it is. One tiny RAM stick. All that work for this little guy hiding on the backside. Pull out the RAM by gently bending the metal clips aside. Look at that. The actual RAM swap takes 5 seconds. Getting here? 30 minutes of laptop surgery. Want to see more unnecessarily complicated upgrades? Check out the complete playlist right here.